हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक विल बी मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ड्रग एक्शन। स्टूडेंट्स, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ड्रग एक्शन इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द फार्माकोडायनामिक्स, बिकॉज फार्माकोडायनामिक्स इज द स्टडी ऑफ द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ ड्रग एंड फार्माकोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट प्रोड्यूस्ड ऑन द ह्यूमन बॉडी। सो इट इज ऑल्सो कंसर्न विद द कोरिलेशन इन फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्शन and chemical structure of drugs. So in case of action of drug, what is the definition of action of drug? So it is a process by which the drug or chemical substance induces change in the pre-existing physiological function of living organisms. And if we look at the effect of drug, so it is the series of changing occurs after drug action is called effect of drug. Example is, in case of fever, the body temperature is elevated and the body temperature is elevated above the normal body temperature. So tablet paracetamol, which is antipyretic drug, is administered. It disintegrates, absorbs, then acts on heat regulating centers in the brain. It lowers the raised body temperature to normal body temperature. So when the drug is administered to a person with normal body temperature, it does not cause hypothermia, brings no change in the body temperature. So what is the site of the action? The location in the body or skin surface where the drug produces its action is called site of action. So the site of action can be of three types: local action, systemic action, and in the body and not in the tissue. So the in local action, it is an action produced by drug on the site of its application. Example is action on skin or mucous membrane where drug is applied. So next is systemic circulation. So it is the action produced on different organs after absorption of drug into systemic circulation and in the body, not in the tissue. So drug used against intestinal worms, microorganisms, ectoparasites, etc. So guys, the drugs do not impart new function to any system, organ or cell. They only alter the pace of ongoing activity. So the basic types of drug action can be broadly classed as stimulation, depression, irritation, and replacement. So if we look at the principle of drug action, drug may act by virtue of physical and chemical properties. Please just look at the example. If we take the example of antacid, its property or its action mechanism of action is by neutralization of the excess acid produced. Next is active charcoal metal. It is absorbent. Active charcoal is absorbent in heavy metal poisoning. So next is potassium magnate. So it has a oxidizing property. So majority of drugs produces their effect by interacting with the discrete target biomolecule, which is usually a protein. So the functional proteins that are targets of drug action can be grouped into four major categories, that is enzymes, ion channels, transporters, and receptors. So in case of enzymes, almost all biological reactions which are carried by a catalytic influence of enzymes. So the enzymes are very important targets for the drug action. Example is levodopa, which is dopamine catalyzed by the DOPA. So stimulation of an enzyme increases its affinity for the substrate so that rate constant of the reaction is lowered.
So, apparent increase in enzyme activity can occur by enzyme induction, that is synthesis of more enzyme protein. And inhibition of enzyme is a common mode of drug action. First one is non-specific inhibition, second one is specific inhibition. So it is also further divided into competitive and non-competitive inhibition. So in case of competitive inhibition, the drug being structurally similarly which competes with the normal substrate for the catalytic binding site of enzyme so that the product is not formed or a non-functional product is formed. Example is captopril competes with angiotensin 1,4-ACE. In case of non-competitive inhibition, the drug we do not compete with the normal substrate for the catalytic binding site of enzyme. Example is lovastatin digoxin. So next is ion channels. So the proteins which act as ion selective channels participate in the transmembrane signaling and regulate intracellular ionic composition. So it makes them a common target of drug action. So drugs can affect ion channels either through a specific receptors, G protein operated ion channels. In addition, certain drugs modulate opening and closing of channels. Example is quinidine blocks myocardial potassium channels, nicotinandiol opens ATP sensitive potassium channel. So next is transporters. So several substrates are translocated across the membrane by binding to specific transporters, which either facilitate diffusion in the direction of the concentration gradient or pump the metabolite ion against the concentration gradient using metabolic energy. So hydrochlorothiazide inhibit the potassium chlorine transporters in the early distal tubule. So guys, if just we just look at the replacement therapy, it is when there is certain deficiency in the cells or host body, for example, electrolytes deficiencies, vitamins, hormones, or blood deficiencies. The administration of electrolytes, vitamins, hormone food, etc., is called replacement therapy. So if we just look at the action of drug due to physical and chemical properties, the drugs which cause cell death and lysis, the example is of silver nitrate, strong acid alkalis. So these drugs are called caustics. And the drugs which produce local inflammation are called counter irritants, for example, linemines. And drugs which kill microorganisms by direct action are called as disinfectants. And the action of saline purgative is due to their osmotic property. Example is magnesium sulfate and lactulose. So next is mechanism action of drugs due to biological properties. And the first point is receptors. So a receptor is fundamental tissue component unit in which drug molecule interacted to produce its mechanism of action. So these are the macromolecules, and they serves to recognize the signal molecule, but itself has no other function. But one should be kept in mind that the drug cannot produce any response which is not shown by the tissue. So the following terms are used in describing drug receptor interaction. First one is agonist. So an agent which activates the receptor to produce an effect similar to that of the physiological signaling molecule. So next point is antagonism or antagonist. इट इज़ एन एजेंट विच प्रिवेंट्स द एक्शन ऑफ एन एगोनिस्ट ऑन द रिसेप्टर बट डज नॉट हैव एनी इफेक्ट ऑन इट्स ऑन. सो नेक्स्ट इज लीगेंड. सो एंड मॉलिक्यूल विच अटैचेस सेलेक्टिवली टू पार्टिकुलर रिसेप्टर ऑफ साइट शोज ओनली अफिनिटी. सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज रिसेप्टर ऑक्यूपेशन. दिस थ्योरी स्टेट्स दैट रिसेप्टर एग्जिस्ट इन डायनामिक इक्विलिब्रियम. सम आर इन एक्टिव फॉर्म एंड सम आर इन इनएक्टिव फॉर्म. सो एग्निस्ट हैव बोथ अफिनिटी एंड मैक्सिमल इंट्रिंसिक एक्टिविटी. एग्जाम्पल इज एसिटाइलकोलाइन एंड एड्रीनालिन. नेक्स्ट इज फार्माकोलॉजिकल एंटागोनिज्म. सो बोथ द रिवर्सिबल एंड नॉन रिवर्सिबल टाइप्स ऑफ एंटागोनिज्म आर कॉल्ड फार्माकोलॉजिकल एंटागोनिज्म. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एंटी हिस्टामिन ड्रग्स ब्लॉक द एक्शन ऑफ हिस्टामिन. एंड नेक्स्ट इज फिजिकल एंटागोनिज्म. सो द रिमूवल ऑफ फ्री फॉर्म ऑफ पॉइजन बाई अब्जॉर्बेंट लाइक चारकोल इन द गट इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फिजिकल एंटागोनिज्म. सो नेक्स्ट इज केमिकल एंटागोनिज्म. सो वेन ए ड्रग कॉजेस चेंज इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अनदर ड्रग इज कॉल्ड केमिकल एंटागोनिज्म. नेक्स्ट इज अफिनिटी ऑफ ड्रग. सो इट इज डिफाइंड एज द एबिलिटी ऑफ ड्रग टू ऑक्यूपाई एंड एक्टिवेट द रिसेप्टर्स. एंड नेक्स्ट इज मीडियन इफेक्टिव डोज और ED50. इट इज डोज ऑफ ड्रग विच प्रोड्यूसेस यूजफुल इफेक्ट्स इन 50% ऑफ एनिमल्स. एंड नेक्स्ट इज मीडियन लिथल डोज और LD50. सो इट इज़ अ डोज ऑफ ड्रग विच किल्स 50% ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल एनिमल्स और ऑर्गेनिजम्स. एंड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज थेरापेटिक इंडेक्स. सो इट इज़ अ रेशियो ऑफ LD50 टू ED50. सो द एंटागोनिस्ट हैव अफिनिटी बट नॉट इंट्रिंसिक एक्टिविटी. सो नेक्स्ट इज ड्रग एक्शन. सो इट इज इनिशियल कम्बिनेशन ऑफ ड्रग विद द रिसेप्टर रिजल्टिंग इन कन्फर्मेशनल चेंज और प्रिवेंशन ऑफ कन्फर्मेशनल चेंज. सो नेक्स्ट इज ड्रग इफेक्ट. सो इट इज अ अल्टीमेट चेंज इन बायोलॉजिकल फंक्शन ब्राउट अबाउट ए एज ए कंसिक्वेंस ऑफ ड्रग एक्शन. through a series of intermediate steps that is transducer. so transducer mechanism can be grouped into four categories. first one is GPCR receptor with intrinsic ion channels, enzyme linked receptors and receptors regulating gene expression. so next and main point is factors affecting the dosage of the drugs. so the following are the some factors which modify the dosage of drugs and they are the age. So infants and children require less dose and that is different dose from adults. So in infants and children the metabolic enzymes and excretory process is not fully developed. So similarly old age patients require reduced dose because of organ hypofunction due to old age effect. So next is sex. So male individual requires a large dose of drug in comparison to females which require fewer doses. So some drugs when administered to pregnant women may cause harmful effect to fetus after crossing placental barrier and it may cause fetal abnormality. So next is body weight. So the dose of drug is usually related to body weight. So a person of overweight requires large dose than the normal individual. So if drug is fat soluble then some portion of dose is accumulated in body fat. So large dose is required for fatty individuals. So dose of drug is usually expressed as mg per kg of body weight and a person with underweight requires a smaller dose. So next is route of drug administration. So drugs when administered by intravenous or intramuscular route require less dose in comparison to oral route. So drugs given by IM or IV route have quick onset action. So the action by mouth or a route is delayed and slow. So the drugs given by rectal route are absorbed slowly and only a part of drug is absorbed. So large dose is required by this route. So next point is idiosyncrasy. So when abnormal drug response occurs in an individual, the condition is called idiosyncrasy. So person reacts violently to certain drugs is in unusual way because and usual dose or average dose may have toxic effect to an individual whereas same dose may have useful effect normal to an other individual. So next is physical condition. So the patient with distressing symptoms need large dose of drug. So next is addiction. So it is behavioral pattern of compulsive drug abuse. So prolonged regular use of alcohol, narcotics like morphine, heroin, cocaine cause habituation and results in condition known as addiction. So when such drug is withdrawn, stop use of drug, withdrawal symptoms appear like psychic craving, body ache, insomnia, restlessness, etc. So next point is tolerance. So when a drug is administered regularly to a patient for a long period, it becomes necessary to increase the dose. So the patients develop tolerance. So to produce same effect in the body, a large dose is required. So the tolerance of drug usually disappears on withdrawal of a drug. So next is pathology state. A pathological condition of liver and kidney is very important. So liver is a main site for detoxification of drug. So in case of any disease of liver, the action of drug is decreased. So when there is any dysfunction of kidney, which is main organ of excretion, the action of drug is delayed because of slow excretion of drugs. Next is time. So the time of administration is highly important. So in empty stomach, drugs are more quickly absorbed. So food in stomach may affect absorption of drug. The diuretics are administered in the morning and not in the evening, as it requires the use of toilet several times for micturition. So during night, the sleep of individual may be disturbed. So they are always prescribed for in the morning. So next is genetic factors. The pharmacogenetics is a branch of pharmacology which deals with the genetic variation in response to the drugs. So it has been reported that due to genetic variations, the deficiency of glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase in certain races results in increased toxicity of primaquine. So due to genetic variation in few individuals, isoniazid, that is anti-TB drug, is fastly acetylated, and in some persons it is slow acetylated, leading to more chances of deficiency of vitamin B6 that causes peripheral neuritis. So next is effects of drug on the body. So the therapeutic effects, it is an effect which is desired to cure disease. For this reason, a drug is administered to a patient. The drugs, they are administered for the following reasons. First one is to maintain health. The medicines are given to individual to increase resistance against disease. Example is administration of vitamins. Next is to prevent disease. Vaccines and antitoxins are administered. Example is BCG vaccine, TT2 product against tetanus. So next is diagnosis of diseases. First one is barium is used in X-ray investigations. So certain drugs are given for temporary relief of distressing symptoms but do not cure the disease. Example is analgesics. Next is cure of disease. So by supplying hormone deficient in the body. Example is insulin. So to destroy disease causing again organism. Example quinine in the treatment of malaria. So by restoring normal function, example is digoxin. Next one is local and systemic effects. So when a drug is applied locally, topically to the skin or mucous membrane, it produces an effect. So for systemic use, drug must be absorbed into bloodstream to produce the desired effect in various system and various parts of the body. So next is toxic effects. So larger or higher doses of drug in the bloodstream produces toxicity. So some of toxic effects are fatal for the patient. So toxicity develops due to cumulative effect of drug when body of a person is unable to metabolize the previous dose of drug. And next are the side effects. So these are the effects other than the main action desired, which are as hinder. So first one is allergic reaction. So when a drug is administered to the patient, individual may react to a drug as a foreign body and may develop reaction like skin rash, itching over body, diarrhea, nausea and vomiting. So next is anaphylaxis. So this is a severe reaction marked by fall in blood pressure, local edema, pallor, dyspnea, restlessness, prickling, feeling in throat, edema of face, hands.
cyanosis, wheezing, etc. So it is an emergency to be dealt quickly to save life. So death may follow in few minutes, and penicillin and syrup be administered after sensitivity test has been done. So next is pruritus. So it is itching of the skin with or without skin rash. And next is urticaria. So odymatous pinkish elevations with itching occur over the body due to reaction of a drug. So next is rhinitis. So it is excessive water discharge from the nose, and tears, excessive tears from eyes. So in case of nausea and vomiting occurs, diarrhea may occur due to irritation of intestinal mucosa. And next is dyspnea. So shortness of breath and wheezing due to laryngeal edema is developed. So students, that was all for the day. Thank you.